The fear of the epidemic causes Dow Jones and Nasdaq to plummet. American Airlines swoops, strong sales on Microsoft and Apple that drag the market down, oil is falling. The financial markets globally are in free fall as the world wakes up to the fact that we are in the middle of a coronavirus pandemic. This is a worldwide epidemic. Even here in the United States, we have this one case that everyone's focusing on, but what we failed to miss is the fact that the CDC, because of a problem in getting their test reagents out to the local labs, we've hardly tested anyone. And so here the absence of evidence is not evidence of absence. I think we have a much more robust transmission going on in this country right now that we just haven't picked up. And this is happening in countries around the world. Now 50 countries confirmed, and I suspect it's in many more than that will be confirmed in the days ahead. The coronavirus continues to spread globally. More than 80,000 cases have been confirmed worldwide, including just under 1,000 in South Korea, more than 280 in Italy, and 53 in the United States. President Donald Trump may claim that the U.S. has the coronavirus under control, but health experts and stock market strategists are less confident in the administration's assessment. Japan has called for all public schools to be closed from next Monday to the end of spring break in April. This, as infections outside China now outnumber those inside China. Saudi Arabia stopped the pilgrimage to the Islamic holy sites. Numerous international flights have been cut back or cancelled. Altogether, 50 countries or territories have confirmed cases of the virus. South Korea has again seen its biggest one-day jump in infections, and Saudi Arabia has stopped travel to religious pilgrimage sites due to fears over the virus. In Europe, Italy's outbreak has worsened, while Romania, Denmark, and Estonia are the latest countries to confirm cases. And Australia is taking emergency measures to stop the disease spreading. Numerous international flights have been cut back or cancelled. Countries around the world are fighting to ward off a pandemic. And the Fed is speechless in the face of trillions in lost global GDP output, as country after country becomes economically crippled. Welcome back to the Atlantis Report. Please take some time to subscribe to my two backup channels. I do upload videos there too, on a daily basis. You'll find the links in the description box. Thank you. CNBC reported that the coronavirus already wiped out $1.7 trillion in U.S. stock market value in 2 days. Dow plunges to worst level since December. The Dow Jones Industrial Average is now at its lowest level since early December. The S&P 500 lost an estimated $1.737 trillion in value in 2 days. Bounced hard off of something 150 PTS in seconds. The bounces are inevitable, traders are going on hunting trips hoping to catch bears out. Stocks cratered again as investors fled riskier assets amid intense fears about a slowdown in global growth caused by the deadly coronavirus. The global sell-off is confirming what former Morgan Stanley Asia chairman Stephen Roach warned last month about a massive imminent shock that would hit the global economy. The Nasdaq composite fell 2.8% and joined the S&P 500 and Dow Jones Industrial Average in turning negative for the year. Donald Trump's confusing comments about coronavirus may have contributed to Tuesday's stock market sell-off. And Trump himself may have helped catalyze Tuesday's volatility when he appeared to suggest that U.S. scientists were on the verge of developing a coronavirus vaccine. The White House later clarified that the president was referring to a vaccine for Ebola. If coronavirus becomes a pandemic, it could cost the global economy over $1 trillion in terms of product losses. The heavy estimate comes from the Oxford Economics Institute, which warns against the risk that the spread of the virus in 2020 will burn 1.3% of world growth, the equivalent of $1,100 billion. Moreover, for the economists of the research center, the virus has already shown the first frightening effects with the blockage of the supply chain due to the closure of factories in China. Oxford Economics, in recent days, has measured the impact of the Chinese virus in particular on the Italian economy. A drop in GDP is likely in 2020. If measures to contain the epidemic remain in force for a week, business interruptions will weigh around 0.1% of GDP in the first quarter, economists say, pointing out that this is a conservative estimate. Indeed, other factors, such as trust and supply chain dynamics, are likely to amplify the shock. The four provinces affected, Milan, Lodi, Cremona, and Pavia, are worth about 12% of Italian GDP, 10% of Italian manufacturing production. The financial markets are plunging as investors continued to worry about the spread of the coronavirus. The Dow shed almost 900 points, falling more than 3% to close at 27,081. The S&P 500 also closed more than 3% lower, while the Nasdaq sank 2.8%. The declines followed drops overseas. In the UK, the FTSE 100 fell almost 2% to a 12-month low of 7,018, while Japan's Nikkei 225 index fell 3.3%. This is the black swan event of the 21st century. The economy was collapsing long before this virus. The virus is merely a front to explain the lie to gullible folk. The Baltic Dry Index had already crashed 50% from September 2019, when Fed started repo market operations to buy enough time to sell an excuse in the name of a bioweapon to the people, to December 2019. And when magically 2 days ago they updated the corrupted database on coronavirus, the story was strong enough to sell the markets. Classic front used to fool the gullible people like the one in 2001 to explain the 80% stock market crash. 3 months September to December 2019, which caused the repo market rates to spike to 10%, global manufacturing PMIs were already in recession territory and completely collapsed September to December. Fed had to do $500 billion of QE in a mere 3 months September to December, even faster than the depths of 2008 recession. Yesterday was a hiccup of volatility in a market with a long history of upward movement that has little to do with creating business value. If the coronavirus does have a significant impact on the American stock market, it will produce a much more substantial decline. The prospects for that kind of impact remain uncertain. But there is no possibility of any near-term disappearance of that potential. How well do we understand the flu? The new coronavirus could mutate more rapidly than anyone can understand its characteristics. The WHO has not yet called the virus a pandemic because there is still a chance that nations outside China will be able to contain the virus to isolated outbreaks. If that pattern proves out and the United States never experiences any major outbreaks, optimistic views of stock market potential could easily prove true. But, experience with the flu and the common cold demonstrate the limited ability to control virus spread. If the virus does get out of control even in one or two nations, other places are likely to repeat the experience of Wuhan. Many parts of the world will not do as well as China in managing it. In that kind of scenario, the best hope will be that summer causes the epidemic to subside. The worst-case scenarios would include the spread of the virus throughout the world, with many places repeating the Wuhan experience. The other big concern is the reaction among many Americans that the virus provides an opportunity to stomp on China while it is down. They habitually grossly overestimate the power of American economic aggression. They are also very likely to be grossly overestimating the damage the experience of the virus will inflict on China's economic progress. The combination of a bad American experience with the virus and the consequences of a misguided American economic war against China could easily turn the recent history of momentum-based stock market speculation into a period of American economic depression. The S&P has fallen to nearly the bottom of the long-run channel 2016-present from notably above the top of the long-range channel. In a week. Computers at work because people don't panic that fast. It's impossible. 2008 and there is a good example of when people still had influence. Now it takes machines to spark the flames. People are just adding momentum. This dump will be the inventory, bought cheap and repeatedly flipped, the algos use for the next run up. There will probably be a good short squeeze next week. A market that falls forever will never attract new money. Greed needs to be motivated by a feeling of good fortune ahead. Remember, the financial markets exist for two reasons. The first is for a startup, expansion capital. The secondary markets exist for liquidity, also known as buying paper low to sell it to someone who thinks it's worth more than you paid for it. The financial markets also exist to provide commissions and fees. The algos are waiting for an entry point. It could be next week, or this could be like 2016 and 2019, when the dip was double-sized before it raged back. Or it could be the end of the world. Right now, I'm an optimist and believe it's only a market reset and another relentless play to scare the Fed into QE, MMT, more. All they can do is print more cash for buybacks. You can't print organic growth. To go back to the divergence point of the new modern era and start a new growth trajectory, you are looking at somewhere around 1993. Dropping the Dow down to 3,200 points, effectively erasing the entire dot-com boom and the entirety of the 21st century so far. Any chart you pull up shows the absolute lunacy of the past decade, making the Clinton and Bush bubbles look like nothing. What has gone on since 2016 is insanity that hasn't been seen since the South Seas bubble. The Dow could lose more than its entire value at the peak of 2007 and still be valued higher than the top of what was supposedly the greatest bubble of all time. A 13K point sell-off would be seen as world-ending, but still, leave us with the Dow above 13K. Any bull should be able to see how insane that is. Is our economy really double the 2007 peak? Maybe the Dow dropping 2,000 points means nothing to you, but I'd say it's pretty solid evidence that there is potential for disaster here. Don't buy at overvalued valuations. In short, stay cash and be ready to deploy when markets stabilize. Warning to the public, sell all your stocks now when you still have time. It is smart to take profits now for a decade of rising stock. Do what the insiders are doing. The rich will always get richer. The gullible will lose everything. This is a global pandemic that is out of control. This is just the start. I have sold my stocks and will not buy back for a 2 quarters minimum. This thing with the coronavirus is huge, and it just started. The worst is yet to come, cases starting to rise in South Korea, Iran, and Italy. The COVID-19 incubation period was 14 days then 24, and some say it is even longer than that because some people don't show any symptoms at all. A phone call to Wuhan's funeral home determined that they are handling the cremation 115 to 135 bodies per day. 61% of the bodies are coming from homes, not hospitals. There are 7 facilities like this in Wuhan. Do the math. This was the Atlantis Report. Please like, share, subscribe. And please take some time to subscribe to my 2 backup channels. I do upload videos there too on a daily basis. You'll find the links in the description box. Thank you.